Please be seated. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. السلام على من اتبع الهدى ورحمة الله وبركاته. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. O Allah, He who extended the morning's tongue in the speech of its dawning, and dispatched the fragments of the dark night into the gloom of its stammering, made firm the structure of the turning spheres and the measure of its display. He who demonstrates His essence by His essence, He who knows what will be before it comes to be. O Allah, we ask You for pardon and well-being in this life and in the hereafter. O Allah, we ask You for pardon and well-being in our religion and our worldly affairs, in our families and wealth. Allah, reveal our weaknesses and set at ease our dismay. Preserve us from the front, the back, our right, our left, and from above. And we seek refuge in Your greatness, that we may be attacked from underneath. O ever-living, O self-sustaining and supporter of all, by Your mercy, we seek help. Rectify us, rectify for us all our affairs, and do not leave us dependent on ourselves, even for the blink of an eye. A new adventure is upon us, my dear fellow graduates. Challenges and steps to take. I ask Allah, by Your mercy, we seek help. As we embark upon a new stage in our lives, and service to You, then to humanity, makes us strong in spirit, mind, and body. Amen.
Dr. Cooper, Dr. Pallone, faculty, staff, family and friends, on behalf of my fellow graduates, I welcome you to the baccalaureate ceremony for the Springfield College class of 2018. As we gather here today to celebrate a milestone achievement on our life, we have to think back to the beginning of our journey. We all come from different social, cultural, and economic backgrounds. Somehow, we all found our way to the admissions office at Springfield College. We all have something in common. We all believe in what Springfield College stands for. We believe in the evolution of spirit, mind, and body. Most of all, we believe in helping others, helping those who don't have a voice and those who need a person who will speak on their behalf. Also, we guide those who, without us, can't see the path in front of them is filled with opportunities. We all believe in making our community a better one. We believe in something bigger than ourselves. We believe in humanity. Springfield College believes in us, and that is why we're here today. Now it is time for us to depart this beautiful campus and join the rest of the world, ready to carry on the fight for justice, for social justice, and social equality. As we depart Springfield College, we leave behind lifelong friends as we begin the next chapter of our lives. But one thing is for sure, we have become members of a more prominent family. We have chosen a path less traveled, a way that may not give us fame or fortune, but one that offers far more valuable rewards. Instead, we will fulfill our dreams of making a difference in someone's life. Our time here has been filled with challenging moments and ones of great opportunity. We all have laughed and even perhaps cried while balancing employment, academic coursework, and family life. However, as we reflect back in time, we realize that it was all worth it. As you look to the right and to your left, you will see yourself in others, because we all have similar goals in life. That goal is lending a helping hand. Life is about reinventing ourselves as individuals. Every step we take, every decision we make, will always have special meaning. It is up to you to determine what that meaning is. As we leave Springfield College, this is not the end, but instead a new beginning. It is time to open your heart and mind to the world around you and embrace whatever life has in store for you. Thank you for this opportunity to speak to you with you today. May God bless you all as we begin our journey into our new endeavors. This is SIT Class of 2018. Congratulations.
Good afternoon. My name is Donovan Andrews, a graduating senior from the Athletic Training Program. Freshman year, I entered into Springfield College as a participant in the Cultural Connections Program. Cultural Connections is a program led by the Multicultural Affairs Office before the freshman orientation, where students learn about diversity in college and the world. We learn ways to handle stress of college and ways to help bring others, and especially the students that are younger than us, up. During the next couple of years, I got involved in student clubs such as Student Society for Bridging Diversity and the Y Club, Hall Council, Student Government, and other service and volunteer opportunities. Junior year, I was blessed with the opportunity to act as the student trustee-elect, later becoming the student trustee in my senior year. The student trustee role is granted to one student in each class. I am responsible for being the voice of the students and ensuring their best experience here at the college. The most valuable part of this position is when I am able to involve other students by motivating them and providing them with the opportunities to take a stand for what they believe in. I will graduate from Springfield College knowing I have made impacts on multiple lives and left the school better than it was when I came. Aside from myself, the students sitting before me have also made lasting impacts on the college and the surrounding community. I congratulate my graduating peers in completing this long, difficult journey and look forward to crossing that stage tomorrow. One last parting message, given that we are Springfield, the birthplace of many things, including the work by Dr. Seuss. I'll give you some of his words. 5 lessons in life from Dr. Seuss. 1, today you are you. That is truer than true. There is no one alive who is youer than you. 2, why fit in when you were born to stand out? 3, you have brains in your head. You have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself any direction you choose. 4, be who you are and say what you feel, because those who mind don't matter and those who matter don't mind. 5, today I shall behave as if this is the day I will be remembered. Go confidently in the direction of your dreams while making a difference in the lives of others. And now it is my sincere pleasure to introduce Dr. Mary Beth Cooper, one of my most favorite people on campus, the 13th president of Springfield College.
Hello. How's everybody doing? Good. I'm awfully sorry about the weather, but I'm working really hard on tomorrow. So I think that tomorrow when we're down at MassMutual, it'll be beautiful. But even though it's rainy outside, it cannot change the disposition of everybody here in terms of how happy we are to be together. It's lovely to see so many of you here and your families to come to Baccalaureate, because in many ways this is the beginning of us saying goodbye, something that is really hard for us to do. And so I too am going to borrow some words from another doctor. I have in my hand a book. The title of the book is called A Man and His College. This was written by President Doggett in 1943. I am working during the summer, because so many people say, what do you do during the summer? I'm working on the sequel, A Woman and Her College. But yeah, you would find that not much is different. This is a beautiful book. If you haven't had a chance to read it, it was sent to me by an alum during my first 6 months here at the college, and he said, I think it would be very important for you to read this book and learn about the history of the college. And it really was the journey of Dr. Doggett and his journey as a president. And so as I thought about what I might share with you today, I thought I would read a small piece of how he talks about the beginning of the college. Because as you leave here today, I want you to think about how this institution started, because there's many things that have not changed. So pardon my reading this, but it certainly means something to me. And now I've lost my place. So he begins to talk about the triangle, and he talks about the origin of the triangle, and I'm gonna ask a question. We might as well have a participation. Who knows who started the triangle? Yes, Jess? Gulick, Dr. Gulick started the triangle. So it was under his direction that he began to think about what would be the way, the philosophy that we would start using the triangle to embody the three most important aspects, spirit, mind, and body. And he talked about, and his language talked about it being as men. We now know that he meant to say men and women. And when we think of the triangle as what joins us together, it is, in fact, the one thing many of you will leave remembering. Some of you even have the triangle as a part of your journey with us. And I don't want to see a show of hands of how many people have the triangle. But it is important, because when people talk about Springfield College, nowhere else have I ever been where students are able to talk about what the mission of the institution is. And I would guarantee you that each one of our graduating seniors today would be able to tell you that it's spirit, mind, and body in leadership and service to others, because that's what we do best. And so as you go into your communities and do the things that you do best, what I ask you to do is care for others. Remember the triangle. Remember all the memories that we shared together. But remember that Dr. Gulick, over 100 years ago, decided that this would be the indication of what would make a small regional college a great national treasure. And I believe, men and women, we are on our way. So the note that was in this book that was written by an alum said to me, Dr. Cooper, you have come to a special place with special students. Do good things. And so my message to you students today is you came to a special place, and you were indeed very, very special people that have touched my lives. Now, I ask one thing of you, do good things. And remember that this is always your home. I'm going to not read this section because I think it's not as important as my message to you about remembering that this is your home. You are always welcome here, and you'll always have a peace in our heart. After the ceremony is over today, we're going to have my husband and I, Dave Cooper, are going to host a small reception for all of you back at our house. And for our students, that'll be the last time you come to the house as a student, because as of tomorrow, within 24 hours, you're going to be an alum. And so I hope that you're able to join us, and I wish you all the best in the world. Congratulations.
I leave no regrets, leave something to remember, so they won't forget I was here.
Great dancing, ladies. Good afternoon, family, friends, faculty, staff, and distinguished guests. My name is Brittany Sullivan, and beside me I have the honor of sharing the stage with Megan Robichaux and Kate Pearson. Together we make up the senior class board. We have put together a little something for you all today, and we hope you enjoy it. Listen careful, families, and you might just hear your graduate. Mom, I'm starting first, so you should listen now. I think for the most part, we were all ready to start college, to start something new somewhere new, to have a fresh slate, a chance to decide who we wanted to be and how to go about being that person. A chance to try new classes, get involved, meet new people, and explore a new city. What I don't think we were ready for was Springfield College. Admit it, when you showed up day one and you opened your eyes to this campus, were you not the least bit confused by the immense amount of triangles that surrounded your every movement, no matter where you were? And come on, were you not questioning why you're being forced to wear this baseball cap-looking thing they called a beanie that's two sizes too small, no matter how many bobby pins you wore? And why? Why were there 100 over-dramatic, over-excited students screaming in your face at 8 a.m. about a little red wagon? There is no chance anybody was ready for that. It's a surprise we all didn't run home that night. But 2 weeks down the line, when you were hitting it off with your floor, forming friendships that would last a lifetime, getting to know your roommate, signing up for clubs and intramural sports, and slowly adopting the culture that is Springfield College, which meant coming to terms with all the unheard of traditions that you experienced day one, holding the door open for an extra second or hour for the person behind you, saying hello to everyone you did and didn't know, whether or not they wanted to look up and make eye contact, and keeping off the green grass. Did you not also think you weren't ready for that? Or better yet, expecting that to be what college entailed? But then again, like I said before, you weren't expecting Springfield College. We all made a decision to come to this school. And I don't know about all of you, but I, for one, think it was worth all the hoops we had to jump through and games we had to play, both metaphorically and literally, just to start our journey.
Why did you choose Springfield College?
For the family atmosphere. Can you take that jump? The community. Don't feel the fall. 4 more years of sport.
I like the welcoming atmosphere and smiling faces.
The sense of community and inclusiveness.
For the PT program.
Tradition.
Baseball.
The opportunity to study abroad.
The spirit and body concept.
The humanics philosophy.
Sophomore and junior year. Each time we stepped foot back on this campus after a relaxing summer felt like we were stepping back into our home. It got more familiar and inviting each time. We were no longer the newbies, but we still had so much time ahead of us and so many memories to make. During these years, some of us became the NSO pre-camp leaders that once changed our lives in the hopes to change the lives of new freshmen. Some of us continued to excel and progress in our sport. Some of us found new clubs to join. Many of us began to find our family in a home away from home. But all of us continued to shape ourselves to be the best person we could be, because that's what Springfield College does to you. Graduation is a time to take a breath and realize that you made it. But it's also a time to reminisce and look back on all the amazing times you had in the past 4 years. Remember your favorite spot to hang out in the Union that over the years became your spot. And if anyone was in it, it was an awful tragedy. Remember all the times you spent surrounded by friends and teammates in Cheney Hall, waiting in a really long omelet line because it was totally worth it, or running when you smelled the air in the air that it was a burger night from outside. Remember the times you spent in your residence halls with friends that quickly became your family. Remember the first nice day each year when everyone is outside and in a great mood. Remember both the smallest moments and the biggest milestones. Like that time sophomore year when Lil Dicky decided to host a pre-concert in the backyard of the townhouses. Or that time junior year when the men's volleyball team won the national championship and everyone stormed court. These plus a million more are our memories. Tomorrow you will be walking away from this school with a well-deserved diploma in your hand. That diploma not only holds your greatest academic accomplishments, but it holds your memories. The campus you are on right now will always be a home base, and the moments you experienced in every nook and cranny of this campus are yours to keep. So cherish them and never forget.
Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad.
What was your favorite memory at SC?
When Kate and I ran on the outside of Gulick with a zebra scaring residents.
Being able to move in early and get to know a whole other family at Springfield College.
Meeting my roommate, who is now my best friend. Interviewing Cal Ripken Jr.
Friends in my major who have become my family.
Sayukui.
Leading an alternative spring break.
Stagfield.
Ending spring break in Myrtle Beach with Ultimate Frisbee.
I love the Partners Program.
Everything about NSO.
ACDA.
Winning back-to-back conference championships.
Hanging out in the green.
The Springfield women's lacrosse team made it to the NCAA's tournament. Woo!
I don't have one specific memory, but senior year as a whole was phenomenal, and living in the townhouses was a great time.
I like walking around campus and seeing familiar faces.
Living with all of my best friends senior year.
Watching underclassmen make the memories that I once made.
Attending LTC and meeting some of my best friends.
Getting to be a part of the athletics family.
Having the opportunity to go to Guatemala and serve others.
Going to nationals for women's rugby, even though nobody noticed.
Beating Western New England this year.
I did it all.
Everyone tells you that college flies by. Turns out, they were right. Something changes senior year. It becomes a year of the lasts. Last first day of school, last Stayuka, last finals, last time in a classroom. And just as quickly, it becomes the time of the first. First interview, first job, first apartment, first real paycheck. And then nostalgia kicks in, bringing all the memories back. The good, the bad, and the ugly. With that come all of the emotions. The good, the bad, and the ugly. It's easy to get caught up in the transition. Half of us are sad that this chapter is ending, while the other half are excited, nervous, or anxious to get the next one underway. Springfield College students are selfless, driven, passionate, focused, and so many other things. And while everyone is different, I've found that our student body, and our class in particular, is overwhelmingly humble. Today, you don't have to be. Whether you're done forever or you have class in 2 days, be proud of where you are at this very moment. Whether you've accomplished everything you wanted to here, or you feel as if you still have more to give, you have reached a major milestone today. You made it. You have survived 100% of your days, both at this college and in life. I know that these speeches normally contain a piece of advice or something to hold on to as you start, finish, or continue your journey. Although I didn't realize it at the time, Springfield College gave us our advice the day we arrived on campus. This advice has been with us for these 4 years and continues to be just as valuable on the last day as it was on the first. While I was busy trying to make my beanie look good, which never happened, by the way, the upperclassmen were giving us the best advice they could, and it came in the form of a song. Our class received this song during NSO. The song's name, I Lived. The upperclassmen picked the song for the incoming class, and ours is packed with advice on how to get the most out of life, how to persevere, and how to cherish every moment you make, or every memory you make, sorry. Now Annie, our beloved student activity director and local legend, made a joke about reusing this song in a few years because it was such a good one. And although it was just a joke, I think we've incorporated it into enough of our speech that you get the point, Annie. It's ours. Forever. You can't reuse it. But what Annie and the SC students before us said holds true. It is a good song, and the advice it gives can lead us through life, not only now, during graduation, but for the rest of our lives. For those of you who aren't familiar with the song, I'll share a lyric with you, one that especially stands out on a day like today. I owned every second that this world could give. I saw so many places, the things that I did. With every broken bone, I swear I lived. So from Meg, Britt, and myself, thank you. Thank you for making this our place. Thank you for sharing your highs and lows with us. Thank you for making this song meaningful and for letting us leave Springfield College saying that we lived.
do you plan to do after you graduate?
Get a job as an SLPA.
Become a first grade teacher.
Teach elementary school.
Going on to grad school.
I will be attending Syracuse University for grad school.
Coming back to this wonderful place.
China.
I'm going to be assistant AD at a high school and coach football.
Stay at Springfield College.
Looking for a job.
I'm going to nursing school.
I'm staying here at Springfield College to get my master's in school counseling.
I have class on Tuesday.
I'm coming back to Springfield to get my doctorate in physical therapy.
Love this place so much and they can't get rid of me, so I'm standing here.